James tell us about our ego and about our lips, our mouths. So listen for the words. These are baby voices, so they're very soft and gentle.
Mercy and his love for us. Welcome to each and every one of you. so hard to stand up here when people don't smile. So if you are, I don't know how young our youngest is, up to 16, 17?
16.
Smile. It just makes the afternoon go by so much better. On behalf of Westminster Presbyterian Church and the Community Cultural Arts Program, a center under the fabulous direction of Mrs. Annie Jo Edwards, we welcome you. We welcome your energy.
All right.
Your applause. Your participation. And later, your financial love. Amen.
Amen.
You've got
Thank you.
Yeah, Mr. Powell. And when she was about this tall, she thought she was grown. All she just says, man, cut her eyes and look back at me. This is one of the sweetest ladies that I've ever met. She's bright, she and her sister. Neither one of them were pregnant. Then their aunt told them that everybody in their family had to take piano. All you old school people, who all had to take piano lessons? All these folks had to take piano. I told her she had to practice. This year, she and her sister decided they practice. Wow. She learned that on her own.
Whoa.
Mostly known as the Great Big Apple, there once lived two little girls. One was named Annie, and the other, Dorothy.
Annie, once a poor little orphan, was adopted by a hugely rich millionaire named Daddy Warbucks. Annie lived in a huge mansion, somewhere in New York City, with his butler, Punjab, and Annie's dog, Sandy. Dorothy, also an orphan, lived on a farm in the middle of nowhere, somewhere in Kansas with her Uncle Henry and Aunt Anne.
Don't forget about her little dog, too.
How could I forget Toto?
See what I'm saying?
My bad. Both live in Broadway as hit shows.
Both won Tonys and were made into major motion pictures in the 1970s. Very recently, the two girls wound up lost, somewhere in oblivion. Quite dismayed, Dorothy, who knew how it felt to be lost and away from home, broke into tears.
Being a brave little trooper, Annie sucked it up and boldly said,
tomorrow, there's a weather called Webster.
named Attenborough, who immediately told her about a wonderful wizard who could do just about anything, even get them home.
Child that you told me what it is.
wise and wonderful Liz. Dorothy and Annie gave an enormously loud shout out, summoning him.
Mr. Wiz!
They're gonna
tears came to talk to them, and at the same time talk to myself. You know, you all can be anything you want to be. It's obvious from the most casual observer that you all have talent, wonderful talent, that you're not just academically smart, but you're mutually tough and smart as well. And you have a great amount of talent, because I ain't going for it. Here's a little sweet girl is trying to be Eveline. And I say it to somebody, you know, it doesn't take an actual ugly person to be mean. Sometimes it takes a nice, nasty person. So that's what we've tried to get her to do. So having said that, I want to dedicate the song to the kids. Because one thing I can say in earnest, I believe in you. But at the same time, I want you to believe in me. All right? Fair enough? Believe within your heart, you'll know that no one can change the path that you must go.
I just want you to stand so we can all give you a hand.